Over the years, so many people have asked me, you know, how did your rebounding journey start? Like, where did it start? Why did it start? How did it start? All of that. So I thought, okay, let me really, really think back to the first time I remember rebounding or bouncing on a trampoline. And it happened to be when I was probably about 10, 11 years old, and I had a really close friend who lived down the road, and we had a neighbor who had this outdoor trampoline and it was really cool. And we used to meet there often and ask the neighbor, please give me a bounce. And the neighbor's like, okay, let me lock the dog away. And then we would bounce for until we couldn't like breathe anymore. So we were sweaty and exhausted. And then we used to go home because neither of us had a trampoline in our yards. And the one day it was a very scary experience because the neighbor was away and we didn't know that. So we arrived there and the gentleman that was cleaning the garden and helping in the garden let us in and didn't lock the dog away. And she ended up getting attacked by the dog and it was absolutely scary. It was a terrifying experience. Her entire like inner thigh was like gouged open, teeth marks and flesh and blood. It was horrific. And that was the last time we went there. But I also was a gymnast. My whole sort of junior school and high school, I was a gymnast, and part of our training was to learn how to tumble on the ground. And so we had to use a trampoline to get the height, to practice the moves. And it was always my best session is when it was trampoline day. And we could jump so high and we had all those sort of landing mats around us so we could do the craziest moves and know that we were safe if we had to land a bit funny. So that was like my gymnastics days all the way through my high school. And then I studied to become a personal trainer, and I've got a photo of me when I was 19 years old training my first ever client in the comfort of her own home. And there you'll see in the background is a rebounder. So that was in like, I don't know, 2001, 2002. And that was a long time ago, and it wasn't a great rebounder because at that stage in South Africa we didn't have like really great brands or mine. So it was one of those like local big store specials with quite a bad bounce. But anyway, I've got a photo of me sporting my dark hair and my 19-year-old body, and there I was with my first client with a rebounder in the shot. So like I've got proof that wow, you know, I was using a rebounder all those years ago. And then probably about a decade ago, I was a presenter on a TV show and I interviewed experts as part of my presenting job, always in the wellness industry, and I was exposed to rebounding again, but this time more of a sort of a health modality. I was gifted a rebounder and I started playing around with the rebounder just in between strength training circuits. So, you know, set of lunges, set of squats, set of dips, and then sprint on the rebounder to get my heart rate up. And I would use it as part of a circuit training sort of workout at home. And that was kind of the only way I used a rebounder for a long time, was just part of my workouts. And then I became a mom and I had a bubba. And when Bella was about 5 months old, we went to our farm in Nottingham Road, and I was told by the doctor not to jog with Bella on the jogging stroller yet. She was very small when she was born. Her little neck was not quite strong enough to keep her head still. And to this day, I promise you, I actually don't know what made me pack my rebounder, but I packed it up in the car and off we went to the farm for a month. And I wanted to lose my baby weight. I was 13 kgs overweight, still at 5 months postpartum. I was breastfeeding and I could not lose weight when I was breastfeeding. So whoever says you just shed weight when you breastfeed is lying, because in my case, it didn't come off until I stopped breastfeeding. So I had these like big, you know, whats and tummy jiggling and big butt, and I felt so heavy, and running was actually really uncomfortable because I had pubic symphysis and so my pelvis was like a bit separated and all that extra weight, and my back was so sore from the epidural, and I had this tiny baby that wouldn't take a bottle. She only breastfed on demand. She wouldn't like let me leave her side for longer than 30 minutes. It was impossible for me to go running. So I had to try and find something that I could do like indoors. So I packed my rebounder, and I'm so grateful I did, because that was the beginning of my entire sort of career in the rebounding world. And I was at the farm, and I remember our Wi-Fi being terrible because we don't have Wi-Fi at the farm. So my connection was terrible, my signal. And I was looking on YouTube and I was trying to find really nice workouts. And I found one lady that, and I did all of her workouts 20 times over. She was like my little role model, but I knew all the moves. By the time I left the farm, I knew every single sequence. She had a 15-minuter, she had a 30-minuter, and I had done them so many times and I was so bored. So I started looking for more options, and of course it would get stuck because the Wi-Fi was non-existent. And there was a couple of workouts that were shot in the back of an aerobic studio in a different language, and it was hectic and I couldn't even hear the prompts. I couldn't even understand the language. So I was like just trying to follow, but being big and feeling unfit, I couldn't follow it. Everything was too fast, too dancey, crazy. And that's when I came back to Joburg and I realized, I can't believe that there's such beautiful big brands out there, beautiful rebounders around the world being sold, but yet the content, the workouts that you get with those rebounders weren't great. Like, there was nothing taking you from beginner to advanced. There was nothing incorporating weights or strength training. There was nothing that would like challenge me beyond those like 15 minutes. That, you know, it was just, I couldn't believe the lack of content out there and great, great sort of awesome, you know, properly constructed workouts where I could do it and know that my whole body had been challenged. Cardiovascularly, it was sorted. Strength training was done. The pat down and lymph was done. Stretching, and then also some fun. So I thought, right, I'm going to utilize all my knowledge, the last sort of 17 years or so at that stage. I thought, let me incorporate my years of ballet and love for dance and music, then my gymnastics side of it, and then also my personal training experience of 17 years, and let me put together my very own philosophy, my very own type of workouts that were unique and different. And that is what I spent 2 years doing, was just practicing. And I started doing classes at the hall down the road to get more experience and actually see what clients enjoyed, what they liked. And then I started shooting, lots of little workouts, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, half an hour, and then all the way to an hour. And just recently I've launched my beginners program, and we've got kiddies workouts now, family style. We've got sort of HIIT ones, more guys type focused ones. And I've even invited some of my sort of colleagues that are also huge rebounding fanatics and really good on a rebounder to give me some great content around Lisa Rally and Friends. So bringing their own sort of vibe and slant to the Bouncy program and being able to offer just some different, you know, kind of offerings for people that maybe don't want to do my workouts, but they want to do something different on other days. So yeah, it's just been like, that is pretty much my journey. And I lost all my baby weight from rebounding. I wasn't doing any other training. I was rebounding every single day for about 40 minutes, and then I built it up to about an hour. I landed up getting my flat tummy back. I thought that I would never get my flat tummy back, but I got it back. And to be honest, what I've loved so much about rebounding is that I'm never injured. So I used to run a lot and I used to get injured all the time. I used to have bursitis. I used to have like sore arches of my feet. I used to get sore hips, very sore groin, knees, inflamed, swollen when I ran too much. And I used to run probably 3-4 times a week. I used to do a lot of strength training, and I also got injured sometimes when I did strength training. This is the first exercise that I've ever done where I can do it every day, and sometimes twice a day because I shoot once and then I do a live class or something, where I'm not that stiff. I don't get injured, I don't get swollen. It does everything at the same time. So even though I hardly do weight training now, I still have toned arms, I still have defined legs, my tummy is still defined, and yet I don't do a lot of weight training. So that's what I love about rebounding, is that it's like it works my cardiovascular system. I'm fitter than I've been for years. It does shred the extra body fat. It does work me from a toning perspective, so my body is still firm and toned. I'm never injured, which is a huge thing for me. My water retention issue has totally disappeared. Cellulite has improved, energy has improved, and I think a big thing, especially right now, is my immune system. My immune system is much better now than it's been ever before. I used to have lots and lots of colds and flus, and I hardly get sick. Maybe once, touch wood, maybe once or twice a year I get a cold or flu, and that is it. And I promise you, everything goes down, boils down to rebounding. It definitely helps to circulate your lymphatic system and help to make your body more alkaline. The water retention that I used to suffer from in my legs has totally disappeared. It's a miracle exercise for me. And the more and more testimonies that I'm getting in from clients, and the more and more people that are doing my beginners program and giving me feedback, the more I realize that this is not just, it's not just for me. Like, I'm not the only person that has had these kinds of results from rebounding. All of my clients love it. They say it's fun, they look forward to the class, they work out hard, it's not easy, but whilst they're doing it and they're following me and the music's going, they feel like they're having fun. They feel like they're kind of at a nightclub, but on a rebounder. And that's what's huge. Fun is important, because if you can find something that you love and something that's fun, there's more chance that you're gonna stick to it, you know? Doing something where you don't feel sore afterwards. So let's be honest, at the beginning you might feel sore calves or sore abs, or you might feel a bit stiff, but generally I'm talking about sore as in like not right sore, like you're injured, like there's inflammation and your muscles and your joints are like really not happy. So there's stiffness, but not, you know, soreness, which is not good. There's a sore muscle, and then there's a sore joints. It's not that. So they're able to do it, whereas before they used to run and get injured. Now I've got a whole bunch of like ex-runners that are able to rebound when they can't run anymore, because the running is so high impact. It's so jarring on their joints and stuff, but they're able to rebound and they don't feel any of those pains and aches all over their body. New moms that have got problems with their pelvic floor, you know, when they start rebounding, they say to me, I really, really need to go and urinate. Like the minute I jump on that rebound, it's like something is just set off and I have to like run to the bathroom straight away. Is there anything I can do about it? And I train them. How do you sort your Kegels out? How do you, you know, loop your pelvic floor back up and get it to tighten and kind of just, it's a muscle at the end of the day. It's a whole lot of little connective muscles all together in your pelvis. How do you get that strong and back to where it was before you had kids, so that you don't feel like you need to urinate whenever you bounce? And that takes a bit of practice and it takes a few months. And something that they were told would require surgery, they actually can avoid the surgery by rebounding and focusing on tightening those Kegels and avoid that operation and actually strengthen their pelvic floor by bouncing. So like, there's just so many things that it's so grateful. And just seeing the testimonies come in and seeing people's lives change. Something else that I love about rebounding is the fact that it's so inclusive. You know, you can buy a rebounder and it is an investment. I know it's not the cheapest thing, but at the end of the day, if you buy one thing and it can do everything, cardio, strength, happiness, lymph, boosting immunity, reducing water retention, like everything all at the same time, then I think that's the best investment you'll ever make. But the fact that I've seen Bella go from 9 months old and just, you know, bouncing with my hands and she's sitting there like that and a little core's being used and she's getting used to that sort of feeling, right through to what she can do now, which is crazy. She can pretty much follow one of my classes now, bar all the weights and stuff. She's just so agile and she's flexible and she's her ability has just gone from like nothing to being able to do crazy moves on the rebounder, and she's just, it's so good for her. It's good for her balance, her proprioception. She also loves it. It's good for her cardiovascular fitness and building up those little muscles. So it's like kids can use it. Then you've got your beginner, which who can use it with a little support bar. Then you've got somebody that maybe was a runner or is a runner and wants to do something really challenging on their non-running days, or a cold day, or you know, a winter's day, or maybe they don't feel safe running outside so in the dark. So now they can do something that really challenges their cardiovascular system by using ankle weights and using some of my class style workouts, which are faster, and maybe using the T-bar and being able to jump higher so that you can really get explosive moves. An advanced person is able to use my rebound and get challenged by it. And then if you've got an elderly person in the house, perfect. With a little support bar, that elderly person can do very basic routines, make sure that their lymphatic system is circulated. It helps them with joint mobility, flexibility, cardiovascular exercise. It works against the gravity, so it helps to build lean muscle tissue and bone density. So it's like, it really is the perfect piece of gym equipment for everybody to use. And I don't think there's one other piece of gym equipment out there that's safe for kids, but also applicable to a beginner, also challenges an advanced person, and also the elderly can use, and everybody feels like they are having a great time and getting the benefits. So yeah, so it's just like rebounding has become one of those things that I feel is totally, people just don't know about it. And you say rebounding and people are like, oh, like you mean from a guy? You know, no, not rebounding from a breakup. Rebounding on a trampoline. They're like, oh, that mini trampoline, like for OT and like, you know, for kids and stuff. Like, no, there's so much education to be done still. There's so many people out there that still don't know what rebounding is. So many lives that I still get to change. So I'm excited, but I really wanted to just share with you like my rebounding journey. And it started from many, many, many years ago, and my passion for it has just grown and grown and grown as I've seen the benefits for myself, my own body, my own life, and then those of all my clients, were the ones I've physically met in my classes that have been doing classes with me for 18 months or so. So people online that have finally dusted off their rebounders, pulled them out the garage and started bouncing and doing it properly. You know, focusing on the correct technique, on being consistent with it, starting small, with very short workouts and building their way up, to people that have just bought my rebounder and started. It's just like, it's a whole new world. And I really do encourage those people that are thinking, is this just another fad? Is it a trend? Is it a gimmick? To get yourself a rebounder and to be consistent, start bouncing, because you will see so many incredible health benefits and then weight loss will follow. Like I often say to people, don't focus on weight loss, because wellness doesn't always follow. Focus on wellness, and weight loss always follows, you know, or 99% of the time, unless there's some kind of other underlying condition. So get a rebounder for health, to have more movement in the house, for everybody to get involved, to have fun, to focus on lymph, to focus on circulation, focus on immunity, focus on challenging the cardiovascular system, all of that stuff. And I promise you, you will get the results that you really, really want at the end of the day without getting those injuries. So yeah, that's my story. That's kind of like my rebounding story. If you're looking for something different, if you're looking to try it out, then yeah, check out my website for more information, lisavalley.com, and I'm sure there you'll find all the answers you're looking for. Hope this interview helped. Ciao.